Paddy Mills for PM, please.
And he scores!
Our basketball hero just made Australia proud, leading the Boomers to their first ever Olympic medal. Paddy dropped 42 points and we all lost our minds.
Yeah! Paddy Mills, you're a bloody champion!
Paddy also kills it in the US League, the NBA, recently moving from his long-time home of 10 years, the San Antonio Spurs, to the superstar-studded Brooklyn Nets.
Oh, mama!
Good on you, Paddy!
A proud Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander, Paddy's a social activist, a champion bloke, and now he's an Olympic legend too. Our ultimate ref from the land down under.
Please welcome basketball superstar and Olympic hero, Paddy Mills. Yeah. How's ISO going, Paddy?
Yeah, really good, thank you. It's good to be in the country, first and foremost, but good to get some quiet time and, you know, try and let it all sink in.
Have you set up a little mini basketball ring yet, just to shoot some hoops?
I have not, but I've had some time to just redecorate the place to make it feel a bit more homely.
You're a very good taste, Paddy.
How does it feel to bring home our first basketball bronze? Congratulations, by the way.
Yeah, thank you. You know, it's a feeling for me that's, I think, still forming, and now that I'm back in the country, bit by bit, starting to sink in on you know, not what it only means to myself and the team, but for the rest of Australia. And I think, you know, that's when it will really start to sink in and tears will flow, I'm sure. But it just feels really good to be home.
Everyone speaks about the culture of the Boomers. Matisse Thybulle said he had never experienced anything like it in any kind of team sport. What is so special about these Boomers?
Yeah, look, I think it's the culture. I think it's the understanding of the legacy that's been built before us and then us taking the responsibility. And I think that the special thing about the group was that we all done it together. We knew it was at stake, and it's kind of set up now for the future of basketball and for our country. So I think we've opened a can of worms for what's yet to come.
Paddy, I grew up playing basketball. I grew up watching the Boomers, and the Boomers team's been through a lot of heartbreak. Of course, we've made the bronze medal match so many times, and we've unfortunately been pipped at the post so many times. This is the first time we've won. Watching Andrew Gaze watch you talk, he started tearing up, and it made me absolutely piss tears from my face. Were you aware that you were making grown men all over the country cry?
No, but if you have evidence of that, mate, I'm sure we'll all like to see it. But, yeah, look, I think it's just the special thing about understanding, you know, where the Boomers have come from and the direction that we're heading. So to be able to get over the hump and you know, get that Olympic medal, I think it's exciting for our sport. It's exciting for the country. And, you know, really hope that everyone has felt a part of the journey.
I will say, pissing tears from your face is probably a medical condition. You should get that checked out. Yes. That's really awful.
It did sting a lot.
Yeah, I can imagine. Everyone is obviously raving about your performance. The bronze medal match, by the way, might be the best ever performance by a Boomer in a single game. And just throughout the whole tournament, you were extraordinary. And everyone's raving about how you, when you pull on the green and gold, just reach a whole new level. Can you explain to us why that is? What is it about playing for Australia and playing international basketball that just seems to chime with you so much?
Oh, it's my identity, mate. I'm very proud about who I am and who I represent and what I represent. At the end of the day, that just comes pouring out when I put on the green and gold.
Speaking of home and especially your family, you posted this amazing video today. This is your parents and your wife watching your bronze medal match. Let's have a quick look. So that's called Gogglebox, and you'll hear from our lawyers. But how did you feel watching that?
I hadn't seen it until yesterday, and yesterday was a time where, you know, I could just feel, you know, to see them all three sitting there knowing what they were watching and to really feel the pure joy. That's when the floodgates opened and the waterworks were flowing. But it's special and I can't wait to take this home to them.
I bet. Have you got a big party planned or anything when you're out of ISO?
Well, the party's been going here solo version in quarantine. So.
Paddy, the good thing about the Olympics, I guess, being delayed a year is the next Olympics, Paris, is only 3 years away now. That's the bright side. How are these boomers looking in 3 years' time? We've got Josh Giddey was just drafted. Matisse Thybulle's going to be better. Are you going to be in Paris?
Yeah, of course, mate. Look, I think, you know, what we've been able to achieve in Tokyo is just the beginning. You know, you look at our team, you look at the leadership group, you look at the young guys and the new guys that have been a part of this. It's our culture, again, that's going to bring us closer together and to really understand the meaning. So I think that will carry us on to Paris. Everyone on this team is going to take steps forward and you know, we'll be better by the time Paris comes around. So, you know, GVO, there's gold vibes only, not only now, but moving forward as well.
Oh, hashtag GVO, I like that. during the Olympic medal presentation ceremony, you caught up with your, well, now former Spurs coach and mentor, Greg Popovich. He looked like a really proud dad. What did he say to you?
Yeah, it was a special moment. As we walked out for the medal ceremony and we came through the tunnel, finally there was a fan that was, you know, what seemed like a fan was hanging over the edge of the railing. And when I looked up, it was my coach, Greg Popovich, and he was the only one there and he had his hands hanging as if he was a fan. And I had a moment with him then that, you know, will forever be in my mind. But, you know, the moment that we shared after the game was very special. He's meant, you know, the world to me. I've grown over the decade that I've been with him, not only on the court but off the court. He has been a big part of my life for a long time and, you know, he's in a way been a part of this as well.
Paddy, you had another moment after the medal ceremony where you saw your now new teammate, Kevin Durant. I think we've got the moment I'm talking about right here.
Get out of here, man. That's my teammate.
Hey,
right
yo.
Cheers.
Hey, Paddy coming back to the BK, black tall, and white.
Hey. Now, Brat, you tall man. Is that for basketball non-aficionados, can you explain that technical language you use there, Paddy?
Well, I think everyone can understand that I was shocked to see actually how tall he was. And I've been playing against him for you know, 12, 13 years now. But to get up close and personal like that, as a teammate, I was still quite shocked.
Paddy, congrats again and good luck with the rest of ISO. Thanks so much for your time tonight.
Thank you very much, everyone. Thanks for having me.
What an absolute legend.
Yeah.
And so he's just left the San Antonio Spurs to join Brooklyn, this super team. If you get a chance, have a look at what San Antonio put on their Twitter feed. Like, it's a four-minute package just paying tribute to Paddy Mills. Wow. And you really see the scope and how much they love him. Not just the on-court, but what he's done off the court as well. He's huge.
Yeah.
It was such a great moment. Like, bronze medals are not something we focus on in Australia. But that just has...
That was
it's more than a medal.
Perkins like, Swim and some yeah, of stuff. Freeman, you know.
We'll look back on it.
What a great video, and we've got plenty more, so why not click the subscribe button here? Or is it here? Or is it... Sorry, I can't see the button. I'm not wearing my glasses. But you can see it, so you click on it to make sure you don't miss any more content.